WUJM, St. Petersburg.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Doctors in the House Health Show on 99.1 FM, WUJM, St. Petersburg Community Radio. We have an excellent program for you tonight. Please stay tuned.
Hello, hello. Good evening to you all. You're listening to 99.1 FM, WUJM, St. Petersburg Community Radio. I'm Dr. Morency, your host for the Health Show. Tonight we have a very interesting show. I wouldn't say not interesting, urgent show for you tonight. And if you really have any time or opportunity to call, do so at 727-637-2416. We'll try. The topic tonight is the novel coronavirus or COVID-19. This is a very urgent subject at this particular point, very relevant to the time we're living in. All right. So what I really want to emphasize tonight is there are many things that as an individual that we can do. This is a crisis. And obviously there is the state, there is a local, there's the local government, there's all those agencies who are supposed to help us. However, as individual, we have our own responsibility, okay? Even though this is a new virus and this is really rampant around the world, as a matter of fact, this is an officially a pandemic now, meaning that over 124 countries are involved. And you know, by watching the news, all those people are really getting sick and actually dying. So what is it that we as an individual can do for ourselves, and also to protect our family, our community? And that's basically what we're going to talk about. And the importance of that is that this is not the first epidemic. And personally, as the host of the show, I'm just retired from practice about 2 years ago. I've been doing this for over 35 years. So this is not the first crisis I've been involved as far as epidemic is concerned. So this is going to be from a personal perspective, from a family physician perspective to you. I'm talking to you individually and your family. That's the responsibility. Obviously, you all know about the news. Since the appearance of this virus, by the way, the name of the virus is, the official name is really SARS/CoV-2. Because there was a SARS-CoV before, okay? That's the official name of the virus. That virus caused the disease that we now call COVID-19. That's the outbreak that started in China in December. And since then, as you're aware of, every day you hear bad news. The world has been upside down with increasing mortality, rapid spreading of this virus around the world. There are a lot of uncertainty, a lot of anxiety, a lot of fear. In the word of the expert on the subject, we are in uncharted territory. Now, uncharted territory because this is a brand new virus and there's so much to learn about it. But at the same token, this is not the first coronavirus in the family. Okay, we've had experience with MERS. Especially there was the epidemic in 2012, and we've had SARS. SARS is the respiratory syndrome, COVID-1, and we experienced this epidemic in 2002-2003. So this new one here, the SARS-CoV-2 or COVID-19, I'm going to refer to it as COVID-19, is really spreading among the countries, among human beings, just like wildfire. However, we can use the lesson we've learned over the past regarding that family of virus and any of those typical viral epidemic, you know, the flus, we can learn the lesson from them and apply them now until we fully understand the full power of this virus. Obviously, everybody's asking about the vaccine because that would be very nice and simple. Where's the vaccine? Is there any specific medication to control the virus? The answer is no. Okay? So individually and as a community, there are measures that we can and must do to protect ourselves and our family and our community against this current threat. You are being bombarded with information coming out from regular and social media outlet every single day. All meaning, good meaning, folks, you know, people who have actually expertise on those fields. But keep in mind that a lot of those informations now are speculation because there are things that we don't know. And those speculations can be, for a moment, can be scary and confusing. So what I want to do tonight is really give you a primary care perspective. Because out of all those information that I have digested from the official sources, you know, the World Health Organization, the CDC, and a lot of those expert opinion around the world, I can really summarize this for you and put it in perspective as to what you need to do. Because, as I said, I have had personal experience with the swine flu vaccine. I was probably one of the first one when there was the HIV epidemic when I started practice around 84. And I cannot claim I know what you're going through, but I have an idea what you may be feeling physically and emotionally about this. And if you have any time during the show, just call us, okay? 727-637-2416. First of all, I don't have to tell you what's going on, okay? So the virus is here in town, in the United States, I mean, and in your neighborhood, in the state. So it's everywhere. And you all know all the information because there is 24/7 coverages and you're hearing about all the prognostications and probability by the expert. But here's the challenge. And this is what I want to do for you. The challenge is right now, while we're dealing with this threat of COVID-19, we are in the middle of March, which is officially still winter. Okay, we are in the middle of the flu season. We are in the middle of a cold season. We're also in the middle of the allergy season. The flu currently is inactive in our community, in many communities. So what happened to you when you wake up one morning and you have this cough, runny nose, you're sneezing, you may have aches and pains? What's going on through your mind? What can you do? What do you do? I'm sure you're thinking, is this the flu? Is it common cold? Allergies? Oh God, am I infected with this? Obviously, my advice to you tonight is this. If you are sick enough, don't waste your life. Call your doctor or go to a medical clinic to be seen. Okay? However, we all know the reality. If for some reason you are unable to, you don't have to go to the detail, and you have to stay home to take care of yourself, what do you do? Well, from a primary care perspective as a family doctor and from a public health perspective, there's two questions I want you to ask yourself. Number one, do I have a fever? And number two, where have I been? Have I been traveling? Where have you been in the last few weeks? Have you been exposed in any way? So those two questions are very important epidemiological questions, public health questions, the fever and your exposure. Okay? And as far as the fever is concerned, let me tell you why I ask this question. The temperature, for instance, 100.4 and above is significant right now. Because the majority of people with an intact immune system